Hello friends, I am Anirban from FusionTech, and all of you are both welcome from FusionTech. Today is the 27th series of Tech News, and friends, I hope that all of you enjoyed the Tech News series. So let's start today's Tech News. So friends, today's first Tech News: Reliance Jio to launch 4G VoLTE features phone starting rupees 999. Coming soon. So Reliance Jio is reportedly planning to launch a feature phone with 4G VoLTE support priced between rupees 999 and rupees 1500. At least two such low-cost Reliance Jio VoLTE features phone are said to be planned by the company, which will come with the bundle of free voice calls and other services. According to a report by Hindustan Times, Reliance Jio will use spread Dtron chipset enable 4G VoLTE calls on rupees 1500 features phone. That report said that sitting unnamed people familiar with the matter, the Reliance Jio expectedly in talks with Qualcomm and MediaTek, which account a huge chunk of a processor used in smartphone nowadays. So that's 2 4G VoLTE features phone by Reliance Jio are said to be the offering up at present. However, there is no clarity to launch timeline of this device. According to IDC's quarterly mobile phone tracker, Reliance Jio was fifth biggest smartphone vendor in India in Q3 2016. So second tech news is that Nokia Android phones expected as HMD Global send invites for February 26 event. So HMD Global has started sending invited media events for an event on February 26th February, where it is expected to reveal more Nokia branded Android smartphones. HMD Global, the company that owns rights to the Nokia brand and had an early teased more smartphone launch in sideline of Mobile World Congress, that is MWC 2017, even next month. So according to the official invite, Nokia event will take place of Barcelona on February 26, and it will kick at 4:30 p.m. local time. That means 9 p.m. IST. The official invite say that they invite all of us to join us and to Barcelona. So while the invite doesn't say much about expected device, but it's widely expected that HMD Global may reveal more than 100 smartphones at MWC 2017. So friends, third tech news is that Facebook edition is being tested and it looks like a Snapchat discover. So it was reported in December that Facebook is looking for test the new features called collections, which will be revived. Rival of Snapchat's Discover features for the unlimited Discover is where publishers create a special edition of content just for Snapchat, even video inside to Discover features as sort Snapchat's traditional wording and format. Now it looks like Facebook owns answer to Discover is ready and called edition. And Facebook put an announcement on its newsroom this week, saying that it is exploring format to allow multiple instant article to be shown in one place. The newsroom post said that starting 12th January, they will begin to test a way for publishers to combine multiple instant article into on one post. So the social media giant also announced that journalism project to work with media house and to help them as a Facebook Live as a tool discover new storyline formats and also work on weeding out of fake news. So fourth tech news is that 2016 MacBook Pro finally receives recommendation from Consumer Reports. So after a long time holding his recommendation based on its previous test, product testing from Consumer Reports has now given recommendation to Apple's 2016 MacBook Pro models. The updates rating comes after the company based released a software fix earlier this month of the bug that was delivered to be causing the battery life issue on the laptop. So consumer reports say that in the new report, the software update released by Apple on January 9 fixed the problem that it encountered in its earlier testing. So the three MacBook Pro models tested by customer reports include two 13-inch models, one with Apple's new Touch Bar, one without Touch Bar, and 15-inch model. The new average battery life result on the aforementioned laptops are in order to 15.75 hours and 18.75 hours and 17.25 hours respectively. Consumer Reports said that to recall, 2016 MacBook Pro models were first Apple laptops not to receive recommendation from Consumer Report, and inconsistent battery life was the primary issue because of which firm didn't give its nod to the laptops. So fifth tech news is that Huawei Honor 6X to be available via Amazon in India. So Huawei unveiled in its new smartphone Honor 6X last week at the CES 2017. While the smartphone is already up for sale in US, the Chinese handset manufacturer recently revealed that it will be launch the device in India on January 24, 2017. Further revealing the information regarding the availability, source familiar to the development have told the Mobile Indian that Huawei Honor 6X will be exclusively available in Amazon. So earlier during the press conference at CES 2017, Huawei also revealed that it will bring Android Nougat update for the device sometimes in Q2 2017. Apart from that, the new update will also bring Huawei new EMUI 5.0, which was first launched with Meta 9 last year. As for the specification, Honor 6X runs on Android 6.0 Marshmallow with EMUI version 4.1 top. Other than it comes with a 5.5 inch, that means 1018x1920 megapixels, pixels, and full HD IPS display with 2.5D 2.1 gigahertz plus 4 cores at 1.7 gigahertz chipset with the Mali T830 MP2 paired GPU with 3 GB RAM plus 32 GB internal storage or 4 GB RAM and 6 GB internal storage. In both cases, the internal storage is expandable via the macro SD card. And Honor 6X supports a dual camera setup, a backup combination of 12-megapixel sensor and a 2-megapixel sensor. The setup comes with face detection, autofocus, that means PDF, LED flash, etc. At the front of them, there is an 8-megapixel sensor for its selfie. So, sixth tech news is that Google Maps latest update adds booking payments integration for ride services. So, Google Maps has announced a new update which will bring more integrations with ride services like Uber, making it easier for users to book to ride directly from the navigation app. So, with today's update, that all of you will now see more types of ride options or more affordable information when you open ride services mode. Instead of a long list of ride service providers and ride options, you will see the map you know and love along with the careful of ride service, and see a complete list of ride options and special offers or promotions. Say, and all have said that Google's product manager. Back in March of last year, Google had introduced a ride sharing tab into Google Maps that allow anyone to see the potential pricing and the timing for ordering Uber or Lyft ride. So, according to the blog, a user can log into their Uber account while inside Google Maps. They can took a ride and track the driver on the map and connect with the driver on call right from with the Google Maps app, very similarly to how it works with Uber's native mobile app. So seventh tech news is that Opera Neon, a modern web browser concept. So web browsers aren't always interesting. They have a tax purpose and don't always see the sort of innovation that could be exciting. Opera, which is now owned by a consortium of the Chinese company, has decided to live in this app. Initially, this is not the first time Opera has tried to make a second web browser along with the default Opera web browser. Sometimes ago, they launched Coast browser for iOS device, which also had focused on minimum and clutter-free browsing experience. So Opera opened Neon for the first time, and it's become very clear that this is not a standard fair web browser, such as like Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, which you have been using all along. So the home screen has your favorite website, and as bubbles placed in such a way that the fluid likes to the floating around the screen. So there is a media control panel as well, which lets to manage playback of media content that will be embedded by in web pages. So presently it doesn't support any extension in the kind we are used in likes of the Google Chrome web browser. So 8 techniques that Facebook tested mid-roll video ads. So this story was delivered BI intelligence and Facebook quest for new channels for advertising is promoting it is to get mid-roll video ads according to record. So this is crucial for the company because it may help it deliver reaching maximum ad load or the most ads it can show users without unstability and unsustainability regarding their experience on the website or app. CFO David Weiner had implied that this problem could occur declining and revenue growth rates by mid-2017. So some other implications of rolling mid-roll video ads included so that ads can frustrate users while it unclear whether or not users will be able to identify whether or not a video content an ad. So publishers might use the first 20 seconds to tease the remainder of the video and Facebook reporters John and sometimes live video as a test. Facebook began testing a mid-roll ads in live video last August. Over the next 5 years, the markets will especially embrace mobile. Mobile will drive up spending on video, search display, and social, and proper migration of ad dollars away from traditional media, including newspaper magazine. So, friends, today's last tech news. That means ninth tech news is that LG G6 with waterproofing ability wireless charging teased for MWC 2017 launch. So LG is betting big on its 2017 flagship, the LG G6. The bring back is lost of mojo, and last year's LG G5 was heavily criticized for its modular design and wasn't a popular choice among critics. So the company has rolled out a teaser video that shows all of users' demands from a smartphone and promises to fulfill in its February smartphone release this year. Looking at the launch time frame, it can be specialized that the device will be unveiled at MWC 2017. In this video, LG G6 tipped with to the come with waterproofing ability. If this is true, this will be the first smartphone from the company to sport water resistance. The video also hints that the smartphone will be more durable, less prone to screen crack on fall, and have a larger display screen fit into a comfortable body. So a few days ago, LG launched a 5.7 inch QHD plus display that is 14,040 into 28,080 with an aspect ratio of 18:9 and pixel density 564 ppi. So as for other specification, LG G6 is expected to be powered by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 835 processor paired with 6GB of RAM. The smartphone packs a removable battery with a quick charge 4.0, and it may comes with wireless charging well as well. And the body will be made with a mix of metal and glass and have a USB Type-C port. And As for price, WSJ reports that the LG G6 is expected to price in the same vicinity as its predecessor, somewhere between $500 to $600 in Indian currency, roughly 34,000 to 41,000. So, friends, today that's for today. So, friends, I hope that all of you understand today's tech news. And if you have any problem, so please comment below my YouTube video. And please, friends, please subscribe my channel, that is Fusion Tech. And till now, who's that don't subscribe my channel, please, 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 all of you friends, subscribe my channel and please like my video, please share my video and stay tuned with my channel. So thank you very much. That's for today. Jai Hind, Bharat Mata Ki Jai.